Hello, good morning. You're watching Proactive London. Joining us today is the CEO Mark Hood of Coro Energy. A very warm welcome to you because you've had enormous news this week, inking a deal to acquire a portfolio of planned rooftop solar projects in Vietnam. So let's get an idea of the nuts and the bolts of the deal. So you must be very pleased indeed.
Very excited. Not only the Vietnam deal, but we've also just seen another deal being signed by another one of our investee companies, Ion Ventures. So we'll hopefully have a bit of time to have a quick catch up on that one as well. But it's been a very exciting week.
It has, quite right. Well, should we start with the deal that you mentioned then and then maybe move on to Vietnam?
Most certainly. Yeah. So whether you're aware, but Coro signed a deal kind of towards the end of last year with Ion Ventures. Now, for those who aren't aware, Ion Ventures are a battery storage and clean tech company based in the UK, but with assets both in the UK and over in Southeast Asia as well. And the key for us then was obviously to utilise that relationship and work together very closely to be able to execute upon projects within Southeast Asia specifically. Now, last week, the guys over at Ion did a fantastic deal and they have agreed to deliver on their UK-based portfolio with GLIL, who are a very large infrastructure company within the UK. And they've seen a commitment from the guys over there in the tune of about 150 million. So in terms of implied value and all that kind of stuff, it's an extremely good deal for both parties there. And we're incredibly excited and incredibly happy for the guys over in Ion.
Excellent. So Vietnam now. So it sounds like there's a lot going on, Mark.
There is a lot going on, absolutely. And Vietnam is a very exciting place and it's somewhere that we've actually had our eye on for a long time in terms of various different projects that have been happening over there. Equally, you know, obviously we have our portfolio within the Philippines and we have our cornerstone asset in Indonesia with the Duyung gas asset. But Vietnam is something that's really kind of caught everybody's eye, I think. And there's been a lot of people that have been investing quite heavily in Vietnam. And if we look at the news over the last couple of weeks with Mainstream, for example, doing a much larger purchase than ours, it gives that kind of idea and that sense that everybody's now starting to become okay with Vietnam. And there was also, there was a lot of issues in terms of bankability and the way that the PPAs were being paid, but that's now starting to come through. And we're now really starting to see progress, both within the government, with the PPAs, with EVN being able to deliver upon the requirements to be able to execute on the portfolios that they have and the infrastructure and really being able to bring that back up to the demand and really being able to keep it going. So there's lots of kind of key points there for Vietnam that really kind of pushes forward. Now, from our perspective, we haven't gone in with any of those larger projects. We've taken that step back. We're bringing this in slowly. We're taking the small step. We are looking at rooftop projects, which from our perspective fits quite a few different realms there in terms of number one, we don't want to go in too large at this point. Number two, we want to make sure that we've got a good feeling and we've got a good team on the ground. But equally, we don't want to go overspending and then be in the position where we're not capable of being able to execute. So we've looked at these projects in depth. We've taken our time to assess exactly where we are. We've looked at the rooftop portfolios more on the basis that with the rooftop, we don't have to worry about any of the curtailment issues. We don't have to worry about overcrowding on the grid because ultimately we're just selling pretty much direct to the consumer. So if we think about the larger portfolio, it's 150 megawatts. The first step we're taking is with a 5 megawatt project. And in terms of size and scale, if you think about how large that will be, think about an Amazon distribution warehouse and just the kind of the rooftop size there within the UK and just kind of how that fits. But we're looking at large industrial users. So we're looking at steel mills, we're looking at agricultural units, we're looking at production facilities and garment factories and all that kind of stuff. So ultimately we've got good credit ratings, we've got customers that we know have heavy demand cycles, and really the kind of projects that we want to start pushing forward. So like you say, incredibly exciting and really starting to look forward to getting things moving out there.
Yeah, and I think it's really interesting just reading and learning about your company this morning, once known for your sort of oil and gas interest, you're now very much positioned towards the renewable energy and supporting this transition from fossil fuels. Maybe just remind us what the opportunity is here and tell us about this transition and where now you're positioned as a company.
Very good question. So obviously back in the day with my predecessors, Coro was very much focused on oil and gas and picking up the smaller assets and really starting to push those forward. And Du Yung is the prime example of that. We were fortunate enough to get in just at the right point. Indonesia being a fantastic marketplace, the Du Yung asset being in the middle of the basin, which is prolific. The returns on that will be phenomenal. There's no two ways about it. From our perspective, we're now looking really to take that bit further and really starting to look at the clean energy. So gas still fits into that portfolio quite nicely. We won't necessarily look at the oil and the coal projects anymore, but we will look at gas, and we will then obviously look at the renewables and clean energy and any new clean tech that kind of comes into the horizon. But from our perspective now, we are evolving and we are doing that transition. And it's, you know, clearly our strategy now is to push these things forward and really start to really focus heavily on the clean tech side. Not taking anything away from Du Yung, as we've said, prolific find, prolific basin, P2 reserves at, 2C reserves at 495 BCF. It's a phenomenal discovery, and we're really looking forward to pushing that forward, going through with that. And we're working very closely with Conrad, who are the operator, and really trying to get the progress to be made on there. And we're going to start to see some really good activity coming from there soon. But from our perspective, we are taking that step forward and really kind of pushing that forward. And that the ION deal last year was kind of that first step. The GEPL deal was kind of taking that further. The Philippines, we've obviously got the 100 megawatt wind and the 100 megawatt solar projects. They're working through quite nicely and working through the system. The view with the Vietnam deals is that because they are that much smaller, we can push them through that much quicker, and we can then start to see those to be cash generative much, much quicker. And from our perspective, we want to make sure that there is something happening rather than almost sitting in a lull waiting for that news flow to come through. So this is really where we now start to push things forward and really start to go for it, particularly with Vietnam and the fact that we can get the news flow quickly and we can be cash generative off the back of it incredibly quickly.
Sounds good. Marco, thank you for your time this morning. The CEO of Coro Energy here on Proactive.
Thank you very much.